Hi, I'm Dr. Harris, and I'm working as an associate professor at St. Institute of Urology and Transplantation. Today, we are making an important video. Now we have started video education at SIUT, so we decided that first of all, we should start from instruments that we'll be showing, making sequence of surgery videos, but initially, if you don't have instruments, you cannot do anything. So we'll start all the videos from instruments, and we are discussing all the endourological instruments today. So we'll start from the endourological instruments. This thing, which is frequently asked in exam as well and use as well, this is a telescope. The color of the telescope, it tells us with that which lens it has. It is 30 down. You can appreciate that it is looking down like this. It is at the downside. So this is a telescope. We have got few knives over here which we will assemble and we'll show you later. Sachi's knife and straight knife, half moon, full moon, we'll tell you about. This is a cystoscope, and as you can appreciate that there's 22. 22 tells us that this is a 22 FR sheet, and it has got 6 and 8 things which can go from these channels, so we know that. And previously we saw that telescope, the telescope is placed here. So we can take out the telescope and then we can see that this is a straight telescope. The 31 we saw, it was going down. This is a straight telescope, and you can see it over here as well that it's zero written over there. Straight means zero. That was looking down. It was 30. 30 was yellow and zero is green. So you need to know how to place this telescope. You have to put your hand, thumb like this, and then you slide this over the telescope, the instrument, and then you lock it. These are the water channels, and this is the channel which is placed over here. So this is a cystoscope, cystoscopic sheet along with the telescope. So this is ready. Now, first of all, we will see this instrument. This is a very important instrument. TURP, TURBT, all those things are being done. This is a continuous irrigation sheet. This is a double sheet. And you can see that over here there are holes in it, so continuously the water circulates through this. TURBT and TURP is being done through this sheet. This is a 26 FR sheet, water in channel and water out channel is over here, and this is the obturator for this. So we'll try to unlock this, and look, this is the double sheet over here. One sheet is this, one sheet is this, and then we place it inside. It becomes a continuous irrigation sheet, and there is a ceramic beak over it. Over here there is a ceramic beak, so it works as an insulator that once you cutting, the electrocautery doesn't go over here and the instrument it doesn't damage anything. So this is a continuous irrigation double sheet for resection of prostate and TURBT and everything. So we will be assembling this, and I'll be showing you this. And these are other, like we saw that for the cold knives over here. So these are the hot knives. These are with the electrocautery, and this is a Collins knife. It looks like this, straight down. It's a roller ball for coagulation, and this is a resectoscope stuff. So now we will be seeing another sheet. This is a 17 FR cystoscopy sheet. A five thing can go inside. You open it up. There is a zero written over here. Zero is connected with the other zero we place over here, and then you assemble this instrument. Like we have got a 30 down sheet over here. This is the 31 telescope we saw, and then we placed it over here like this, and we connected like this. And these are the instruments through which you can take biopsy. These are the biopsy forceps. And with that, the long, you can remove the DJ. This can be placed in the cystoscope, and then you can remove the DJ stents and everything through that. So this is a very important thing when you are placing a guide wire through the ureter and ureteric catheter. So this is Elbran bridge. You can deflate it, and you can easily adjust it and to your extent, and then you can place the DJ stent. This is also being placed in the cystoscopy sheet we have initially showed you. So it's placed like this, and zero is connected with zero, and then it's closed and then you open it up. So you need to know how to assemble and disassemble these instruments. So this is another sheet. This is a half sheet. You can remove this sheet and you can place this. Mainly this is used for DVIU purpose. This is a Sachi's knife. This is a cold knife. There is no electric in it, and when we place it, so we give the incision at 12 o'clock with this knife in strictured urethra cases. And this half sheet, the advantage of this is that once you have removed this, the sheet remains inside. You can slide the catheter over it through this. So that is why we have got a half. And as I've told you that 21 is written, that means that this is a 21 FR sheet, and 5 FR, any guide wires, your catheter, anything can be placed through this one. A water channel, and this is a active. If it is a active, so your thumb goes towards the main piece. The movement is at the thumb. That is becomes active, and it is this becomes passive. And if it is active, your finger comes towards the thumb. So these are the differences in active and passive. And this is an introducer. After you have, you can place a Foley's over it, and then you can place this introducer inside. When there is stricture or narrowing, it helps, gives some rigid stuff, so you can place it. This is a stone punch. You can appreciate this is a stone punch sheet, which is very important for bladder stones. We've taken out the obturator, then you place this inside. Zero is connected with zero, you close it. Now your instrument is ready, you place a telescope over here. Zero is matched with zero and this telescope is placed. This telescope is locked, and then you connect the light source over here. The camera is placed over here, and then you fragment these stones. You put the stone in this pitch. This is called the pitch of the stone, and then you can fragment them and remove it with Alex evacuator. So this is for the bladder stones. We'll again unassemble it, we'll take out the telescope, we'll place the telescope, then we'll open up the sheet is over here, the punch, the stone fragment punch is here, and then you close it with an obturator. So you need to know, again emphasis, how to unlock and lock these things. This is a very unique thing and very dangerous as well. This is a lithotripod. It is a very dangerous instrument because as it looks, it goes, this thing blindly goes into the urethra, like we place the dilators, Clutton's metal sound dilators. We place it into the bladder, and then we open this, we lose it, that how much we want to lose, and then this, you fragment the stones and then you take them out. So this is a very dangerous instrument because bladder perforation can occur through this. For the bladder stones we use it. This is a lithotriad. And now most of the people don't use it. We are going towards laser and punch and other modalities. We have shown you this sheet, 26 FR sheet, which is being used for TURP and TURBT. First we'll remove the trocar, and then we will put the working instrument. This is an active, as I showed you. This thing is moving, and you can see there is an A made as well, so this is an active. If your thumb is moving, then it becomes passive. So you connect the zero with the zero over here, and then you close it. So this is complete. The water channel will be, this is the out water channel. Over here we'll place the diathermy in this patient. Now we'll use the telescope. As I have told you before, you put your thumb over here and then you slide the telescope over it. Otherwise, it can damage the telescope and you lock it. So your instrument is ready. Before doing that, you have to put some anything you want. You want to place a roller ball or resection piece, or you can you hear the sound. Over here is a button, you press it and you can remove it, and then you can place this inside the sheet like this, and zero is connected with zero. This has been closed, the ruler is outside, energy is connected here, water is connected here. You press the button and you start coagulating. And continuous irrigation sheet, the water goes in here, inside it comes out and it goes out from here. This is a ceramic beak. Works as an insulator. We have used it uretroscope over here. This is the offset we have told you, and over here it is written 8 and 9.5. So this is 8 and this is 9.5. So it is thin from the front and thick from below, because it has to negotiate into the ureter to the kidney. And this is a semi-rigid. This is not a rigid, this is a semi-rigid URS. There's a flexible URS which we'll show you as well. And there's a rigid as well. So now people use semi-rigid and flexible URS. Now we'll come to the upper tract. We are discussing endourological instruments. And this is a URS. Everyone has used it and seen it. We've got two URS. This one is of 6FR URS, and is made by Wolfcom. And this is an offset. This is called an offset because it goes straight. This is the URS with a light source over here, and this is an offset. And over here you place the whatever you want to use, laser, or you can use a lithoclast. We'll be showing you through this channel inside. And this is the working channel for the guide wire, and you can place a ureter catheter, whatever is needed. Over here, the water in and out channels are over here. So this is a URS. This is of 6FR, and this is a URS. Offset again, URS, and you can see on the lateral side that it's written the size. It is 8FR URS. The why two sizes? Because of different patients need different things. Because if you have to place these things, if you can appreciate, this is a biopsy faucet, the small one. These things can be placed in the 8FR, and if you only have to fragment the stone, then you can use the other. This is for DJ removal or any foreign body removal from the ureter. You can use this if you can appreciate. So these are the instruments of the URS. And last but not least, this is the lithoclast, which is being connected to the machine, and then it is being placed into the working part of the instrument, and you can easily place it into the patient and fragment the stone like this. It goes and you press, and if you can appreciate, it comes out. You press, there is a jackhammer, pneumoclast, pneumatic lithoclast, and you can fragment the stone from this. If the stone segments are small, you can take it out with those forceps which I have shown you, or otherwise you can leave them alone if they have been fragmented well. So you can take out from this. So this is all about URS. URS is used for diagnostic purpose as well as therapeutic purpose, for treating stones, diagnostic to check the site of hematuria, take any biopsies to know why there is obstruction, and then you can take the biopsy from that upper tract TCC, or there is a stricture. You can perform a retrograde study as well. What do you do in retrograde? Retrograde means from down to up, antegrade means from up to down. So if there is a PCN place, you do place a contrast and you check it on the C-arm, that is an antegrade study. And if you place this URS into the ureter and you place the contrast from here and you get a study from below up, from ureter to the kidney, that is called a retrograde study. So you place the contrast from here and then you take a film and you know that what was the reason of obstruction, is there any obstruction or not, that can be diagnostic as well, and you find that as well. So it has got diagnostic and therapeutic use. Another important thing, this is the ureteric catheter. This is approximately 70 to 80 centimeter. It is being placed out of the urethra, and one end is in the kidney or the ureter. So this is open-ended. You can the urine can pass through it, and this is an external drainage. It goes out. Mostly, it is being used for postoperatively for PCNLs. This comes in 4FR, 5FR, 6FR, as well as 7FR. While discussing this, and if you don't discuss the most important thing in urology, this is a DJ stent, and as you know that it has got also FRs. This is a 4.8FR DJ stent. It is totally 30 centimeter in the front, this 15 centimeter this loop, and 15 centimeter this loop, so it makes it 60 centimeter in total. So one loop goes into the kidney, this one, the up one, and the below one goes into the bladder, and Y double J because it looks like a J and it looks like a J. So it is called a double J. Few people call this as a ureteric catheter as well. But mainly we use the name for ureteric catheter, which is an external drainage. And this also comes in 4.8, 6, 7 FRs. And even for endopylotomy, 14 FR digestent, that is endopylotomy stent, which is 14 FR at the top and 7 FR at the below. So that is called an endopylotomy stent that is being used. This digestent has to be removed after 6 weeks maximum, because otherwise there is incrustation and the stones will form over it. When we are discussing this digestent and ureteric catheter, then we have to discuss about this guide wire. This comes in a J shape and straight as well. It comes in 0.035 as well as 0.025 and 0.03 as well. And it is 150 centimeter in length. And this is another glide wire. This is also 150 centimeter in length. And it is a bit soft, hydrophilic, and you can easily negotiate through this when the guide wire cannot be passed. Rigid stuff, now we'll be discussing about the flexible. This is a flexible cystoscope, and this is a complete flexible cystoscope, and this is the light source and the working channel, and then you can deflate it and you can appreciate that it's turning, and then you can deflate it down as well. So you can see the lateral wall, you can see the lateral walls, you can see the dome, and you can see. So it is used for office cystoscopy and for diagnostic purposes. This can be done under local anesthesia. This cystoscope is useful for that. And while discussing this, this is the connector to connect these things. And then the most important thing, which is the flexible URS. Now this is a flexible URS, and these are the working channels for this. And again, you can deflect it in the calyx, in the kidney, and up and down, right, left, lateral, to find the stone. And then this can be used for diagnostic as well as therapeutic. And while discussing this flexible scope, there is an instrument which is to take a biopsy from this flexible, and you can remove a digestent or anything as well. While discussing this, these are the dilators, facial dilators, which can be used for dilating the ureter. Light cable can be seen, and this is the urethral access sheet. Urethral access sheet is being placed into the ureter, and then it goes into the pelvis. And there are two advantages: it reduces the intrapelvic pressure, as well as when you have to put this instrument, which we have shown you here, in and out, so it becomes very cumbersome. So if you place this, you can easily remove the fragments through this, through Dormia basket, forceps or anything. So that, there are two advantages. The problem is that in most of the ureters, this access sheet cannot be placed because of the narrowing of the ureteric orifice and the ureter. So we pre-stent those patients. We place a stent today, and after 6 weeks, we go in again, we remove the digestent, and then we place this sheet. The ureter becomes dilated. That is called pre-stenting, and then we proceed. So this is the advantage of a urethral access. Another disadvantage is that it damages the ureteric orifice, and the patient can have reflex through that as well. And this is the laser probe for those that flexible URS we have seen. This is the laser probe, and we can fragment the stones with laser as well, which is called FURS, flexible URS, or RARS, retrograde intrarenal surgery, or ESERS, endoscopic combined retrograde intrarenal surgery. So these are the uses of it. Now we will be discussing the most important, another important thing, which is PCNL. So nephroscope and PCNL. So we'll start step by step. First of all, we need a needle. So we have got these two needles. This is the LP needle and Chiba needle. And we can have a Kellett's needle as well, which looks like this. But it has got double end at it. Unfortunately, we don't have a Kellett's needle. So Michael Kellett invented it, and it had two things at the back that you can remove it, and you can check the water, and you can place it more inside. This is a facial dilator. These are multiple facial dilators. After placing this Chiba or LP needle inside the calyx, or after doing a retrograde study and you find the calyx and you place the needle inside and then you remove this, the urine or the water starts coming, and then you place a guide wire in it and then you place it in the kidney, and after that we remove this. After the guide wire placement, then we put these facial dilators inside and make a track. After we have dilated this till 10 FR, then we place the central rod. This is the central rod. This, and this is olive. You call this olive as well. And then over this, first we place on the guide wire inside this. This is a metallic dilator. These are called Elkin's metallic dilators. So one by one, we start placing these dilators. And one by one, we place them like this. And in the body, the patient is being dilated like this one by one. And eventually we place the other one over it. Like this, we place all the dilators inside. And once we have dilated, this is 10 FR and then 7 FR. And then we dilate this up to how much we want to dilate. So look, this one, three French is increased on every dilatation. So we can go up to 30 French dilatation, and then we place, after placing all these metallic stents which are called Elkin's metallic dilators, then over that we slide the implant sheet. This is the implant sheet which acts as a passage while we place the nephroscope inside, and we place the sheet inside, and then we remove the dilator. Now this sheet is inside the kidney. Then we localize the stone. It has got one sharp end, one normal end. So we have to move it in a very vigilant manner that we don't damage the calyx. And then through this, we place the nephroscope inside. And then we fragment the stone with laser, pneumatic lithotripsy or ultrasonic. So this is implants sheet, and it comes in. If, I'll tell you one more thing which is important as well, that if you are doing a PCNL with 7.5 FR, only straight needle, like a needle, that is a micro perk. And if you are doing less than 20 or 18 FR track formation, that is a mini PCNL. And if you are doing above 20, that is a traditional PCNL, you can use a 30 FR implant sheet as well, depending on the size of the stone. Now the things are changing and the sheets are reducing in size, so we are using a 20 FR nephroscope and sheet. So we'll be discussing things in detail, and then we'll come on nephroscope and how to assemble it. These are the dilators, the or ureteric catheters, which can be placed. This is the forceps for stone removal. While doing PCNL, you have to remove the stones, the fragmented stones. These are different size sheets and a dilator. This is a single use dilator, you dilate it, and these are the implant sheet we have already discussed. This is the most important thing, which is a marker. You have to have a marker, because whenever you mark the anatomy, then it becomes easy and less cumbersome, that you can have good results. This is the light source cable which we place for the light, and this is the ultrasonic device through which we can fragment the stone with ultrasound sound technology. You place it on the stone and then you press it. It absorbs the stone as well, and it takes out, fragment the stone as well. This is the ultrasonic type of stone fragmentation. And this is the lithoclast, which is a pneumatic lithoclast. Jackhammer, it fragments it, it breaks the stone, and then we remove it via the forceps or irrigation. So now we have discussed already about the glide and guide wires. The length is 150 and everything we have discussed. So this is the nephroscope. So nephroscope is, I have told you sizes of the nephroscope. This is, it has got a 12 degree lens and a 20 FR nephroscope. Yeah, it's written over here, 20 FR. So you hold it like this and you fragment the stones. Light cable goes here, the water channel in, out, and then you can have this sheet. This is the nephroscope sheet, and this is the nephroscope. So the main purpose of this is stone fragmentation telescope. It has got offset, and the camera is placed over here, and then you go and you fragment the stone from here. You place it through this, it comes out, it fragments the stone, and then you remove this and then you place forceps inside from the working section, and you pick up the stones, you pick up the stone, and you remove the nephroscope completely from the implant sheet. This is the implant sheet in the patient. Can you please hold it? Implant sheet in the patient, you hold this, and then you go inside like this. The patient, you hold the stone, and then you take out all the complete nephroscope along with the forceps. A few people think that we only have to remove the forceps. No, it will get stuck over here and it can damage the telescope. So we have to remove the complete nephroscope with the forceps. And this is a stone, we have held it and then we completely remove it. So this is the procedure of PCNL, and in simple words, these are the instruments which are used in PCNL. Laser can also be used. We have shown you a laser fiber in URS that can be used as well for fragmentation. And ultrasonic and lithoclast pneumatic combined technique is also the master lithoclast, and now MOSES technology is there. So MOSES instrument can be used and multiple new modalities are coming. So this is a nephroscope and these are the parts of nephroscope. FR is written, angle and the telescope, everything is written on it. So these are the main instruments for performing the PCNL. Thank you.